Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. First of all, let's say thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has given us guidance, happiness, help, and mercy so we can attend and participate in this special event without any obstacles. Praise and salutation upon our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who had brought us to the path of light from the darkness in this life. Secondly, I would like to welcome all of you to the fourth guest lecture of Generator 2021 with the topic Developing Halal Ecosystem Based on Digitalization. And this session will be brought by Dr. Ririn Tri Ratnasari. Well, to take advantage of the time, let us start this event by reciting Al-Fatiha together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrahim. Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas sirata mustaqim. Sirata ladina an'amta 'alaihim. Ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. Before we start the class, I would like to remind all of you to turn on the camera if possible with the microphone off and write the point which can help you later in the QA session. Without any further ado, I would like to invite our moderator, Mrs. Puji Suchia Sukmaningrum, SECIFP, as moderator for our event today. Please welcome Mrs. Puji Suchia Sukmaningrum.
Okay, thank you Kak Filza. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Your Excellency, our guest lecturer, Ibu Dr. Rin Tri Ratnasari from Universitas Erlangga, and then all the participants, lecturers, students who have attended this virtual mobility virtual students mobility program. Good afternoon, everyone. Before we start this lecture again, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Puji Suchia Sukmaningrum as a moderator, and I also the lecturer in Islamic Economics Department, Universitas Erlangga. Okay, in this afternoon, our class will consist of two sections, same as in the morning. In the first section, our guest will present the material about developing halal ecosystem based on digitalization. And then we move to the discussion section. Please, participants can ask the question by raising hands or writing in the chat room. Okay, before we start, allow me to introduce our guest lecturer. Name is Dr. Ririn Tri Ratnasari. She is an associate professor in Universitas Erlangga, and he focusing teaching in Islamic marketing management, the aspect about halal destination marketing and Islamic marketing, human relationship marketing, Islamic human resource management, Islamic leadership, Islamic business management, wakaf, and also wakaf management. She has a lot of publication in a Scopus journal, international journal, and also many conference, attending many conference and publication in proceeding. Okay. Next, I want to invite Dr. Ririn. Assalamualaikum, Dokter.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
How are you?
Selalu ya.
Apa baik, kabar?
Alhamdulillah baik.
Okay, Dokter, please, maybe you can deliver your material, maybe about maximum 60 to 90 minutes.
Pas ya.
Just one a half hours, and then we can continue to discussion section. Okay, time is yours.
Okay, thank you, Ibu Puji. Alhamdulillah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahirabbil alamin, wassalatu wassalamu ala isrofil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi washabbihi ajmain, amma ba'du. First, thank you to Allah for giving safe and happy for us, and thank you for Associate Professor Asma Abrahman and Dr. Bayu Arifianto that facilitated for this joint mobility student program between University of Malaya and Universitas Airlangga. So in this day, I will share to students who attend here and do not sleepy, no worries. I will share my pictures in my lecture. Is it view? Can see my screen?
Yes.
Alhamdulillah. Yes. Okay. And then I will present about developing halal ecosystem based on digitalization. This with I is make full. So before we talk more, about how developing halal ecosystem based on digitalization, there is four content, four big content about halal dalil, and then global halal market and industries, and halal ecosystem industry, Indonesian halal lifestyle center, and halal supply chain. And then we talk the peak of this topic, that is halal ecosystem based on digitalization. First, as we are mu'min, so if we talk about halal, so we talk about Quran Surat Al-Baqarah verses 168. It's about and the translate mankind it from whatever is on earth that is lawful, halal, and good, toyib, and do not follow the footsteps of Satan. So lawful and good, toyib, it means quality, good in ingredient, hygienic, nutritious, and imar not ifsad, I mean imar not ifsad itu adalah it have construction not ruination, so tidak merusak faal tubuh dan pikiran. And then Al-Baqarah verse 168 tadi, and we talk about Quran Surat Al-Isra verse 70. This make us motivation to do many research about halal, about halal that we can do, not only for food and beverage, but in everything that we can consume, this two verses, and the final verses is Quran Surat Al-Anbiya 107, and we did not send you dear Muhammad, peace and blessing be upon him, except mercy for the entire world. The entire world, not just Muslim, but a mercy for the entire world. So this is very important for us, for us, especially for Muslim, So as we know, about the halal, according to dinar standard, that the sale and purchase of halal product reached 254 billion and boosted the economy 1-3% of GDP, gross domestic products, in member countries of the OIC. So I think this is the one of the maslahat, from Quran Surat Al-Anbiya. If we consume the halal products and then we produce halal products too, and three aspects of halal and toyib, when we talk about definition of halal, that halal something that is permissible according to Islamic syariah and three aspects of halal and toyib, namely not containing haram elements, providing positive impacts, benefit, and not hurting the mind and body. And then product certification and service certification, we have prepared, yeah, and support by government. So this is very, very important for us as a philosophy. Why we always, yeah, not stop, yeah, always do research and do many, many research and development to for practice, for businessmen to supply the halal food, et cetera, et cetera. And then in global halal market, yeah, many players from every sector of the industry, from the huge multinationals down to small enterprises, are looking to capture their share of this growing market. Yeah, we always know about the brand, brand corporate brand from abroad, like Unilever, Nestle, Tesco, Colgate, etc. are some examples. As students who know about Islamic marketing, remember about Eti Kearney. Eti Kearney, he is owner's global marketing consulting firm from US, yeah, that have offices and brands at 40 countries in the world. So big company, yeah, about the consultation company. He said that since Muslims, yeah, are the fastest growing consumer segment in the world, any company that is considering how to serve them is missing a significant opportunity to affect both its top and bottom line growth. Yeah, so that's why Unilever, Nestle, Tesco, Colgate, yeah, the companies are from Islamic countries, yeah. So they always have awareness to serve Muslim market that have very, very big market, profitable market, yeah, to supply halal food and beverage, etc., and toiletries, etc. And then the if you look the picture, yeah, the consumption value of the world's Muslim community is $3.2 trillion by 2024, yeah, from all product aspects. You know, this is about halal pharmacy and then halal cosmetic and Islamic finance. Yeah, so this is show that for global Islamic economy, yeah, we are optimism having market size very big, yeah. We can see it from the picture, yeah. Islamic economy market size is very big, from US to, yeah, 0.107 at 2017, yeah, billion, yeah, increasing to be 3,007 billion at 2033. It's very, very big. And if we see the figure, yeah, we can Malaysia, yeah, can find that Malaysia always many years, yeah, always in the top for production, yeah, production halal industry, and it's a good practices, yeah, this is a good practices. So Indonesia still 10, yeah, rank 10, and then alhamdulillah increasing into 5-10. But Malaysia is the big, and then United Arab Emirates. So they have implemented about the halal ecosystem is very good, yeah, it's very good. And we talk about this total spend, yeah, from Indonesian position. So Indonesian position, the spending, the biggest is halal food, and then halal travel, and halal cosmetic, and halal travel, yeah. Then The report estimates that Muslims spend 2.2 trillion in 2018. I remember about my picture before. Across the food, pharmaceutical, and lifestyle sectors that are impacted by Islamic faith, inspired ethical consumption needs, and this spending reflects a healthy, healthy 5.2% year-on-year growth, and is forecast to reach $3.2 trillion by 2024 at the cumulative annual growth rate or CAGR. So this is a big, a big opportunities for this. And then, the according to Global Islamic Economy Report, alhamdulillah Malaysia and then Indonesia have better performance because halal ecosystem in Indonesia very supported by government too, Indonesian government and local government and other stakeholders have collaborated to increase the halal ecosystem performance, So for about total spend, this high number strengthens the potential of of the halal culinary market in Indonesia as lifestyle that is widely accepted by community. So this is interesting market, but a pity, because Indonesia still as a consumer. Still as a consumer, importer the biggest in Muslim country is Indonesia. But we can see the exporter. The exporter is only in non-Muslim countries, Brazil, Australia, India, France, China, Sudan, Netherlands, and Australia supply the meat, and China supply the biggest fashion products. So this is we must aware of this, and then we can go to shifting, to be a consumer, to be a producer too, And the global halal market and industries, that we know about the halal market is very big. So we should aware about how to make collaboration between halal industry and a halal ecosystem. And Indonesia Halal Lifestyle Center, based on government priority, in sectors foods, beverage, fashion, tourism, entertainment, and media, recreation, pharmacy, and cosmetics. This is halal industry. What's the difference about halal industry and halal ecosystem? It's very, very different, because industry, industry is a collection of different companies offering the similar products, In halal industry, we can see about the fashion industry, food industry, toiletries industry, logistic industries, cosmetic industries, etc., etc. And then, and we talk about halal ecosystem. So we talk about link, that correlation between halal industries, that have a production manufacturing like halal pharmaceutical, halal food and beverage, halal cosmetic and personal care, halal ingredient or service, halal logistik, Islamic healthcare, and Surabaya, the local government at last month have set launch about Surabaya medical tourism. So we can make collaboration about halal medical tourism, Islamic healthcare, and etc. That Islamic healthcare and medical tourism can collaborate with another another industry about hotel and then tourism, etc. And in halal ecosystem, we have collaborate about human capital, because the main problem in the development of halal industry and ecosystem is the aspects of human resources, which will have a good impact on the rapid development of halal industry because it provides a better perception and understanding of the market and how to make production and distribution optimized. So, yeah, and the halal ecosystem must collaborate with government support, yeah, and infrastructure, and the last but very important is technological support by blockchain system, artificial intelligence, IoT, etc., etc., to make trust, yeah, for the consumers. This is, yeah, government support for halal industry. The Sharia Economic Development Framework refers to the Indonesian Sharia Economic Master Plan and the existing Sharia Finance Blueprint. And this proposed framework has a vision as the center of the Islamic economy in the world and focus on strengthening the Islamic economy through three pillars. Yeah, the first is development of halal industry value chain and increasing institutional effectiveness, strengthening, supporting infrastructure, yeah. So we know when we talk about value chain and supply chain implementation, so we have advantage reducing cost and risk, yeah, because the advantages of one supply chain system can cover the shortcoming of another supply chain. And improve communication between collaborating companies, yeah, and increase asset utility and working capital, etc., etc. So Indonesia has 24,000 more of Islamic boarding schools, yeah, with 3.9 million students. Halal product development, yeah, can be carried out with the OPOP, yeah, the one pesantren, one product. So this is more focused strategy so that each Islamic boarding school has a superior products, yeah, because more focus for that. And halal regulation, yeah, from government has halal assurance system from MUI, etc., etc., until SNE for halal slaughter and poultry, yeah, and alur, yeah, this is alur proses sertifikasi halal can be accessed by online, so not so complex again, yeah, because many SME, yeah, then micro SME, yeah, still lazy, yeah, maybe lazy or very very complex, yeah, so they did not getting halal certification because very very complex, but in government now, yeah, can be more simplified and registration can by online, yeah, like this, yeah, and more cheaper, yeah, and manage subsidy, yeah, from local government. So Sharia Economic Master Plan from Indonesia, yeah, strengthening the halal value chain, yeah, and utilizing the strengthening the digital economy. So this is very very important for now, and berkah maslahat from pandemic COVID-19, so there are many shifting paradigm of behaviors, yeah, not only consumers but the businessmen and medium enterprises or micro, yeah, small medium enterprises too, yeah. And research development, yeah, for halal ecosystem, yeah, we have modernization of halal slaughterhouse and then developing system logistic, yeah, based blockchain technology. We can maybe you can see, yeah, clearly about the figure, yeah, the second figure, this is a blockchain technology simple, yeah, this is collaborate about halal certificate body and then food safety certification body, suppliers, manufacturers, storages, yeah, distributors, retailers, consumers, and always they shared ledger and smart contract. Yeah, this is a blockchain technology. So halal food, yeah, one of the halal industry. food safety, halal tayiban, sorry, halal tayiban, ya, 0% unhealthy product content, so non-Muslim also tend to accept and willing to use halal products. Yeah. In fact, halal expectations extend beyond food consumption and include other areas, yeah, such as logistic and supply chain. And then Muslim, yeah, non-Muslim, Muslim for non-Muslim consumers, yeah, the halal logo represent a symbol of cleanliness, quality, purity and safety. And then non-Muslim and some my research has more preferred, yeah, to buy halal products because of the reason, yeah. But and Muslim not only the maslahat, yeah, the benefit like that for Muslim consumers. So halal food is a product that has gone through a halal certification process, which is marked by inclusion of halal label on the packaging, yeah. Something like that, yeah. And this is, yeah, halal fashion. Yeah, remember, in 5 years latest, many Russian Muslimah visit to Indonesia to learn about Muslim fashion. Yeah, alhamdulillah, it's big, very big market potential. Yeah, and halal fashion is very, very good market. Yeah, this is halal fashion, and many macro, yeah, and medium entrepreneur, yeah, that have halal fashion and mark distributing, yeah, and have communicating, yeah, by digital. So it's very, very good. And about halal tourism, yeah, in Japan, Netherlands, we they are non-Muslim, but they are aware about the demand, yeah, about the demand of Muslim when they go to Japan, Netherlands, and Japan have halal airport because it has separated prayer room, yeah, and halal tourism in Thailand, yeah, at Phuket, Bangkok, Chiang Mai, yeah, have Muslim destination and halal restaurants that easy to find. And we know about halal industry in Indonesia, very fast growing, yeah. And halal top brand at 2019, yeah, Wardah is a cosmetic category, the best brand in Indonesia. And then restaurant category, KFC, etc., etc. But in Link Aja, yeah, the company very, very aware with the demand of customers, yeah, with Muslim customers. So Link Aja have for specific Muslim that have green logo, not only red logo, yeah. And this is about halal logistic, yeah. I take from Iron Bird's case, yeah. Then Iron Bird says that halal assurance system certification is no longer a trend, but a necessity in supply chain services. So a transformation of halal and toy-based distribution business services is needed. So it's very, very important, yeah, because supply chain management, yeah, is a system that encompasses the planning and management of all activities involved in sourcing and procurement and logistics management activities. So supply chain management integrates supply and demand management within and across companies, also includes coordination and collaboration with channel partner, yeah, like suppliers, intermediaries, third-party service providers, and customers. This is a supply chain management logistics as simplified. Flow of goods from supplier, procurement, manufacturing, and physical distribution until end of customers. Yeah. And halal logistics too, yeah. The encompasses about production, processing, packaging until sales and present, yeah, to online store or offline store, yeah. And then Iron Birds have online store too and offline store too. And for offline store, yeah, they have partner, yeah. Partner and many partners, yeah, from 2012, 7-Eleven until Bread Life, and then Solaria Susite, and until 2020, yeah, Silver Queen, Fiber Cream, Estelar, etc., etc. This is best practice for Iron Birds that supply halal logistic. Yeah, he ensure that everything from logistic that he manage is sure that's halal. And then challenges into digitalization. So pandemic COVID-19 as a result of the work from home and social distancing policies, the external environment is becoming more dynamic. The speed of technology updates is getting faster and creativity is getting higher. And customers now have high health awareness. Yeah. And then shifting paradigm, everything that can start from home. Yeah, shopping, yeah, buy food, bahkan tes healthy, ya. Yeah. This is always from home, yeah. And then the next challenge is digitalization. So as a businessman, as a supplier of halal industry, must aware of this digitalization. And digitalization is the use of digital technology to transform a business model and provide new revenue and value generating opportunities. This is a process of moving to digital business. Yeah, we know about Indonesian population structure dominated by millennial and Generation Z. They are digital generation. Yeah, after wake up from sleep until yeah ready to pray and to go to bedroom, always open the smartphone. And the result of 2020 population census show that Indonesia is dominated by young people, especially millennials and Generation Z. Yeah, these two groups cover 25.87%, yeah, and 27% of the total population of Indonesia. So it's very, very big market. Yeah. We know about internet use, yeah, 73%. Yeah, they have very, very share their time to open the internet, school, yeah, from home to yeah, open the internet, shopping, gaming, yeah, etc. And then yeah. Factors affecting consumption, yeah, not just income, price, taste, and preference, and available of good and service, but the technology, yeah, who the more simplify access, yeah, easiness, yeah, for use, yeah, so they will buy online. Yeah, this is very, very interesting. And we know about the faster shift towards technology in Indonesia at when. And 20, yeah, COVID-19 plans to continue with new behavior. So we know that in total, yeah, for main activities that we can see this, yeah, on this, so 94% they have time to surf, yeah, surfing on the internet. Yeah, this is a new paradigm, yeah. This is must aware, yeah, for entrepreneurship to do, yeah, everything marketing communication by digital. And further change toward technology today for 48% more people are buying things online compared to 1 month ago. Yeah, and then online shopping, yeah. Always is a new life situation, and then have a behavior, yeah, to shopping online, but the Indonesia's transition like this is likely to opt out. Yeah. This is very, very important, yeah, to for businessmen to aware about this. And COVID-19, Indonesians are adapting to the new normal, yeah, shifting from online to online shopping, yeah, until food delivery service, yeah, everything we can do from home. We work from home, but not reduce, yeah, our productivity, yeah, and then we can, yeah, buy something, yeah, that what we want, yeah, etc., etc., from home, yeah. And laboratorium, you know, prepare the additional service as home service, yeah, to consult with doctor via online tool. This is very interesting. And digitalization is a time to improve the ecosystem for startups, yeah. But not only startups, yeah, use digitalization. Many micro and small and medium enterprises use marketing communication by digital. Use digital marketing, yeah. Use digital marketing, yeah. And then build skill sets for the future, yeah, including updating your education, strengthen regional cross-border digital collaboration. Yes, that's important. And promoting lifelong learning and counteracting the brain drain and super technology adoption by the public sector. So when we talk about startup and non-startup business, yeah, from micro entrepreneur, yeah, they have creativity to make share, yeah, about their products. Even very simple, yeah, product yang ditawarkan, seperti kalau di Jawa Timur ada farmer, ya, selling ayam lidi, ya, for champion, ya, for kejuaraan, ya. Jadi they can share information, ya, ya, to abroad and sell this, ya, and each month they earn until 10 until 20 million. Alhamdulillah, ya, something like that. So digitalization is make more easy, ya, for our business too. And halal ecosystem based on digitalization. This is the peak of this talk, ya. Then in halal health, ya, pain points in Indonesia healthcare and pharma industry having rising, ya, very very big market, ya, because pharma sales representative, ya, and they know about the challenge maintain health communication with professional due to limited face to face meeting. So the collaboration, ya, as a supplier in Halodoc, ya, and then in Halodoc, digital technology, yeah, can help healthcare providers address their current accessibility issues. Services will be provided more broadly and reach remote rural areas. So patient tidak perlu, yeah, consultation in offline, go to the hospital, go to the clinic healthcare. No, not yet. Yeah, tidak perlu. Jadi by download application HelloDoc and then can share about what's the problem of the body and getting the medicine, yeah, and collaborate with pharmacy, etc., etc. So artificial intelligence, yeah, manage, yeah, and can dapat dioptimalkan, yeah, for halal industry and halal ecosystem. So what's the example of artificial intelligence use, yeah, in halal industry, yeah, or general, yeah? We know about Tokopedia Salam. Tokopedia Salam is the first e-commerce in Indonesia that specifically sells halal products, Muslim fashion, and services related to the needs of Muslim. Tokopedia is said to be Salam as well as Tokopedia by Assalam. Yeah, which means that the contract that occur at Tokopedia Salam should be in accordance with Syariah contracts. Yeah, easy to find. Yeah, easy to find the Tokopedia Salam because you only download Tokopedia and then open, yeah, open the Tokopedia and get the menu Tokopedia Salam. So the difference between Tokopedia Salam and Tokopedia is only in the payment method mechanism. And Tokopedia Salam priorities payment through Islamic Bank. Yeah. This is Tokopedia Salam. Yeah. So we can see in this, yeah, that Tokopedia Salam is one of application with Tokopedia in general. Consumers only need to write Tokopedia Salam on the Tokopedia application, then the application will change its appearance to the Tokopedia Salam feature, so that consumers do not need to download the application again. And difference, yeah, between Tokopedia Salam and Tokopedia in general is that Tokopedia Salam has a halal filter feature that helps users to find halal products easily. We know that the menus, yeah, is very, yeah, sangat bervariasi. This is the feature of Tokopedia Salam. Zakat mal, donation, syariah investment, wakaf, yeah, and Al-Quran prayer schedule, yeah. And then from donation, yeah, the Tokopedia Salam get positive response from customers, yeah, because when he offering a donation, Tokopedia Salam has a donation feature whose transactions are trustworthy and reliable. Yeah, on April 2020, Tokopedia together with the community collected a donation and, yeah, getting 7.3 billion rupiah to help 131 hospitals and various health institutions, yeah, that need assistance in 29 provinces. Yeah, that's interesting, yeah. And another feature is fashion muslim. So Tokopedia Salam recorded the high enthusiasm of the people to shop for Muslim fashion products, yeah, and Muslim fashion has almost doubled in transaction. Yeah, worship equipment and then halal food, yeah. The head of Tokopedia Salam, yeah, said that based on Tokopedia's research, more than 80% of users have a need to buy food labeled halal. Yeah. Because, yeah, Indonesia have majority is Muslim, so that Tokopedia Salam come to make easily, yeah, for ordering halal food. And then halal beauty, yeah, there are various halal face care, makeup and mask products. This is the Tokopedia Salam as an online store, but an offline store, we have many, yeah, many stores, yeah, that have an online digital marketing too. And next is halal media recreation. Yeah, the success of series, yeah, began to be felt and then followed by the presence of series Ustadz Millennial in Ramadan. Before, yeah, Jadi Ngaji is the movie from Halal Media Recreation, yeah. And then Jadi Ngaji is most favorite movie from GoPlay. It's an example of the realization of Islamic nuance serial shows with the delivery of a universally positive religious message and a light approach. This series is different and more modern. Yeah. So that both shows succeeded in attracting the attention of video on demand platform. Yeah. And consumers through the religious message contained in these shows and led to higher and positive consumer evaluation by previous research. and many research yeah do and focus yeah how to evaluate about the response of consumer behavior about halal media recreation. So this is show about the synergy of creating a syariah media in an entertainment industry as a step to optimize the halal economy in Indonesia. Islamic shows are offering that are shown to viewers and contains Islamic moral message in them. So this is very important, yeah. Islamic moral message, because many movie, yeah, then not in a good, yeah, not educate well, yeah, for us or for our children, yeah. And the use of voice of demand platform that makes it easy for individuals to watch the shows of their choice through their gadgets. Islamic broadcast through the video on demand platform have undergone a digitalization process. So it's very interesting, yeah. Interesting until 2021 is a good response from customers, and customers can see not go to the movie yeah at the mall yeah at the shopping mall, but only can attach from home yeah. So the response of customers has been researched by Statistica yeah. Statistica research said on 2018 research, the number of voice on demand platform users in Indonesia reached 15 million. Yeah. But until March 2020, there was an increase in the number of video on demand platform users in Indonesia. Yeah, and by 20% and continued to increase to more than 50% during the pandemic. So halal industry and specifically in halal media recreation industry is very, very good, yeah, and very, nah ini ya. So we can see about BTV original ya, yeah, the movie about Ustadz Milenial ya, yeah, jadi ngaji. Nah, now Netflix ya, yeah, students from Malaysia always know ya yeah, about Netflix, because Netflix is the first syariah TV streaming service provider in Malaysia ya, yeah, tanya. Alhamdulillah, Indonesia hopefully will be launch too ya, yeah, syariah TV streaming ya, yeah, and then very very important ya, yeah, to make to prepare and supply yeah, about positive movie ya, yeah, positive drama ya, yeah, etc etc. So the slogan from Netflix, open stream ya, yeah, sociable streaming TV that provides positive content ya yeah, for all users to enjoy safely, comfortable, and sure based on Syariah principles with very Islamic shows from original production content, podcast, nasyid, yeah, and drama. Yes, very interesting. And here about the issues, the blockchain on halal tourism. Yeah, blockchain. Yeah, is a list of public records or public ledgers in which transaction between parties are registered. Each record or block is secured using cryptography. Blockchain is able to provide increased transparency and security in transaction. Yeah, so that's why blockchain until now is the technology that very very safe, yeah. This allows the halal tourism industry to use blockchain technology in understanding halal tourist travel transaction, and many yeah, many industries use the blockchain because the motivation is safety mode safety. And blockchain not only in a general entrepreneur and general business, but in wakaf wakaf blockchain is very familiar. And then we try I cited about the blockchain and halal tourism. And blockchain and for halal tourism is one of the most important aspects of blockchain technology that is always lead data, big data and the data is decentralized with information being shared over a peer-to-peer network. Each block contain transaction and time information and blocks are also permanent and cannot be changed without the consensus of the entire network and without changing all subsequent blocks. So a pupil that do not have in a circle of the blockchain cannot access. And this is very, very important. And technology blockchain pada awalnya mungkin terdengar membingungkan juga But it's very, very easy to be understand because blockchain is a list of catatan publik seperti itu blockchain on halal tourism Mr. Safri Haliding share about the potential application of blockchain technology in halal tourism have many advantages is about tracking halal products and facilities. So the existence of blockchain technology allows tracking of products, component, and halal facilities in detail. Tracking halal product and facilities and make sure that the product is halal. Then the tourist, from segment Muslim tourists, can consume safe. And the second is baggage tracking. Using a decentralized database makes the process of sharing tracking data between companies much easier. Tidak sampai tertinggal bagasi. Or maybe in transit, in airport tidak sampai terjadi bagasi salah tempat. And then identification service. Blockchain technology helps reduce check-in times at airports. Tidak perlu check-in. This is minimized time, more efficient. As a simple fingerprint, it's enough, when the tourist, come to the airport, and then only simple to make a fingerprint, or retina scan, can replace the display document. And then secure and trackable payments. The app can function as a global ledger, making bank payments simpler and more secure to allowing travel companies to accept payments using Bitcoin and other cryptocurrency. But actually the blockchain can use not without Bitcoin. It's more easy for the payment. And the last advantage is the customer loyalty scheme. So blockchain helps travel companies simplify process, allows customers to more easily access information about their loyalty points and allows tokens to be distributed. So customer loyalty program, So maybe in the next, tourists can share their destination experiences, giving review in a chatbot, and can make review where the interesting destination in Indonesia maybe or in Malaysia, etc. But actually, I realized that in Malaysia, the tourism strategy is very, very interesting from customers, from airport, into hotel, they have get a map what will they go in many destinations. Yeah. That's very important. Then halal media. This is one of example. Yeah, this is one of example about blockchain. Yeah, when we use halal media and recreation value chain. So value chain. Yeah, about halal media and recreation value chain industry. Yeah, so the, including distributor. Yeah, have big industry about rumah produksi. Yeah, TV and radio. Yeah, penerbitan, provider aplikasi and games, and then music industry. Yeah, and for payment. Yeah, including perbankan syariah. Yeah, etc. And investor, ya, and incubator, festival kebudayaan, universitas, ya, and digital economic association, and the substitution, and then the supporter, ya, about research and development, ya, etc. etc. So this components can make related, ya, to make blockchain, ya, to be a good services, to be better services for customers. And one of the media and recreation that halal is Nusa. Nusa is target children, yeah, children segment. This is halal media. But how about we can arrange how it works to be a blockchain, yeah, blockchain technology that we use at halal media and recreation value chain. So we can do a research, yeah, and this is a trigger, yeah, for you, for students who have who enter a subject thesis or dissertation, can explore more, yeah, how about developing blockchain into halal media and recreation, into halal tourism, into halal food, etc. etc. Okay, and ternak Nesia. Ternak Nesia is the first and biggest digital livestock platform in Indonesia, and this have focused office at Surabaya. This is one of supply chain traceability. Ternak Nesia, yeah, is a digital platform for livestock solution, not only investment services to livestock. It has developed into a marketing platform for livestock products, which is now the company's main focus. Yeah, this company started by the problems of the farmers' low productivity and unreliable of halal information product in Indonesia. Maybe it's not clear, ya, the picture, ya. Ternak Nesia, you can searching, ya, about Ternak Nesia and have many products that it sell, ya, into online media. So about halal supply chain traceability, ya, this is very important in halal food, ya. But not in halal food, ya, yeah, in halal beverage, ya, automatically, in halal fashion, can, ya, yeah, etc. etc. So halal supply chain traceability allows all products by Ternak Mart to be guaranteed halal through digital supply chain tracking, ya, yeah, from upstream to downstream. So supply chain tracking, ya, yeah, is starting from livestock production, then slaughter, yeah, until the entire distribution process reach the consumers. Nah, ya, yeah, Ternak Nesia, it's a solution, yeah, Ternak Nesia, but digital farmer ecosystem, yeah, on the ecosystem and their circle, yeah, not ecosystem as a whole, to upgrade productivity and innovation on livestock sector, inject information technology system on production process, create marketplace to shorten the long supply chain, and establish traceability system to give halal information to consumers. The company based in Surabaya and cover all around Indonesia. Yeah, this is the one of the platform IG ya. Instagram, etc., etc. And this is about the mechanism. Yeah. Mechanism for halal supply chain traceability. Yeah. And ternak at Ternaknesia Farm. This is need processing storage into yeah. And customer, how about this? This according from farming. From farming, make sure that the farming, make sure the foods, is good, halal too, and then processing, storage, and for slaughter, and to store, and to end user, this is collaborate many parts, and this is on the system of halal traceability, the EPIX is a electronic product, is a GS1 standard that enables trading partners to share information about the physical movement and status of products that as they travel throughout the supply chain from business to business and ultimately to consumers. It helps ensure the what, where, when and why question to meet consumer and regulatory demands for accurate and detailed product information. So in the halal traceability system implemented by the company in tracking or tracing production at Ternak Mart, every meat product sold will be labeled using a special code of EPIX. This is a special code. And then in Bandung, Indonesia, Ternak Desa have a same implementation. And the owner create a tools for their branches, for making sure is it out of stocks or still full, etc., etc. And then for making sure about the farming, to know about is the buffalo sapi then can eat with nutritious food or not, this is very good tools from Bandung, and the owner is student from Institute Teknologi Bandung. This is interesting. So we can see about the special economic zone. They say maybe in Riau, one of the KEK, kawasan ekonomi khusus that government make specific into specific treatment to do better services. So economic zone including Islamic halal related SME and then Islamic finance and then halal value chain and halal tourism and big four into have a good performance into support for a special economic zone. In halal tourism, we have Islamic event, mosque and musola, syariah and Muslim friendly, syariah or Muslim friendly hotel and cottage, halal restaurant, culinary, and then Muslim friendly destination for halal value chain, yeah, make sure that raw materials, yeah, and then halal logistic processing industries, halal port, yeah, halal research and development, and halal authority, yeah, can synchronize too, yeah, and then Islamic halal related SME, yeah, handicraft, yeah, for souvenir, yeah, for tourists, yeah, and then Muslim fashion, food and beverage, halal food and beverage, or others, medicine or others, yeah, and Islamic finance, yeah, easy for use, yeah, on digital payment on Islamic bank, yeah, always use Islamic bank, yeah, because this is a halal faster, yeah, so melibatkan Islamic banks, ya, peer-to-peer financing, ya, and syariah compliant investment. This is interesting for making, ya, in the national KEK in Riau and Bandung, etc., and making an international collaboration, ya, among halal cluster, maybe Indonesia and Malaysia, Indonesia, Malaysia, and UAE, ya, dan seterusnya, ya, like that. So this is the conclusion that halal industry, yeah, very important, yeah, for boosting the digitalization, and need internet and artificial intelligence is very, very important. And artificial intelligence is digital, but not tidak semuanya, ya. Use blockchain, yeah, and all of this need cellular technology, yeah. This is that's all, yeah, for my explanation, and hopefully we'll be getting benefit, yeah. And back to moderator, Ibu Puji Sucia.
Oke, thank you. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, thank you, Dr. Ririn, for such very exciting material about halal industry, halal products, and others until artificial intelligence and blockchains. Okay, now it's time for us to get into the discussion session. Okay, to all participants, you can drop your question in the chat room, or maybe you can raise your hands if you want to ask directly to our guest today. Okay, is there any question? Okay, while we waiting question from our audience, Dr. Ririn, maybe I can ask one question. I want ask one question while waiting our audience. Maybe you can give us explanation about the challenge in Indonesia. Because as your explanation that in Indonesia still cannot get market share worldwide. So what the challenge for Indonesia to enhance halal products in the market share worldwide? Thank you. We'll still waiting the question for all the audience, all the participants.
Yeah, in boosting, yeah, a halal product into abroad, yeah, because until now Muslim consumer from Indonesia is importer from food, fashion, etc., yeah, that we have discussion before. So it need more shifting paradigm, yeah, and the government have support, yeah, government, micro and small and medium enterprises, yeah, and infrastructure, yeah, that built from government is diperbaiki juga, and then make a collaboration, and then have a good good behavior from many university from Indonesia that have pusat halal ya, research center ya. So many university have collaboration into research and research to do the best ya, to do for making health ya, about SME performance, and then they can grow up ya, specifically in pandemic COVID-19. Many SME has down ya, so and then government too ya, giving many subsidy ya for SME in order to grow and then sustain ya. Nah, one of our duty as academician is help them ya, help them to making growing ya, bangkit ya dari keterpurukan. Jadi ini sudah sangat banyak dilakukan. Dan kemudian having coaching ya, coaching into many SME ya, and you know that in Universitas Erlangga ya, we have 100 more entrepreneur based on startup or non startup ya, and managing by BRIN ya, BRIN institution from Universitas Erlangga that head of Pak Nafik ya, lecturer from Department of Ekonomi Syariah, Fakultas Ekonomi dan Bisnis UNER. Nah, and then from more than 100 startup businessmen ya, they can grow and can develop their business until now and can sustain. Nah, that's very important. Maybe in many university that can coach ya, coach the business that handle from students and then until sustain, it's very important to make a better economic growth ya as a whole ya. And I find that our alumni ya, students that graduate from Universitas Erlangga that I know ya, from subject kewirausahaan ya, Islamic entrepreneurship, and they coaching about Islamic entrepreneur ya, entrepreneurship, and how about to solving the problem and try to make a solution about the need from segment targets ya, and until now they can make sustain ya, they can make sustainability for their good practice, I think, and each of part must do ya, what the best can do to make to help ya, SME others ya, business yang lainnya ya, to grow up and then make to be exporter, because this is and when in pandemic ya, COVID-19, we have awareness, we have awareness about how important for making digital business, and we will get the customers more and more ya, into many from many countries. So it come earning specific ya, and this is need to creativity, let's optimize the capability and then make a innovative strategy and do anything ya that melibatkan customer juga ya, so akan terjadi value co-creation. Yeah, this is very important, value co-creation, because with value co-creation will take suggestions from customers ya, yeah, to make a better service for customers too. And siapa yang untung? So always the businessman, always the marketer ya, will get more profitable, but not only the marketer or the company will get the positive impact, but the customers will get positive impact too. So the both side can get saling menguntungkan. And then we'll have loyalty customers, and then making a good performance for company, yeah, and good business performance, social performance, and our Islamic role is a spirituality performance can better. That's all, Ibu Puji.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Ririn. Okay, we got two questions in the chat room. First from Ibu Sri Haryaningrum, our head of department. Prof. Ririn, Alhamdulillah, insyaAllah, after this to become professor. Okay, please explain again. How exactly build a halal ecosystem through digitalization?
Okay. Yeah, Ibu Sri Haryaningrum. I will share again, yeah, my PowerPoint that how to build halal ecosystem, yeah, based on digitalization. This is the conclusion. How about halal industry and many industry, yeah, and many kind of industry, yeah. There is fashion halal industry, food and beverage halal industry, and then about halal media and recreation industry, then halal tourism industry, etc., etc. And needs, yeah, because halal ecosystem, so not only halal industry, yeah, that yang terlibat, but it used to about the infrastructure, yeah, for halal tourism. It's very very important to for making sure the infrastructure, jalan raya, yeah, for better access, yeah. Nah, and then about the halal food and beverage, this is very important for halal standard, yeah, or halal certification. So based on digitalization, it's always need internet, use artificial intelligence. You know about artificial intelligence is a technology that allows a machine to work like human, yeah. Artificial intelligence operates with an algorithm that allows it to analyze large amounts of data, big data. We always frequently hear about big data. Big data not only for big company like Google, yeah, like Tokopedia, like Elsevier, you know, Elsevier, when yeah, Elsevier use artificial intelligence too. Yeah, Elsevier that supply the health, yeah, with the Lancet and Cell, yeah, and then supply journals that from their service for health, and then they research about bagaimana pasien, ya, mendapatkan terapi dari medicine, ya, dari dokter, kemudian dengan treatment obat yang seperti ini bagaimana, apakah yang ini yang paling bisa menyembuhkan. Nah, semuanya mendapatkan data yang sangat luar biasa terekam di dalam artificial intelligence, and then data-data itu terapi kepada pasien-pasien itu kemudian disimpan, ya, karena mengandung banyak sekali data, ya, mengandung banyak sekali data. Nah, sehingga dengan artificial intelligence yang tidak bisa dikerjakan oleh manusia karena keterbatasan manusia mengingat, mencatat, ya, itu hanya berapa data, sehingga need artificial intelligence yang cerdasan buatan yang dilakukan oleh mesin, oleh robot. Nah, sehingga dari situ kemudian, ya, record, riwayat pasien dengan terapi seperti untuk cancer, bagaimana cancer yang lung cancer yang bagaimana terapi yang terbaiknya, sehingga kemudian di share ya hasil penelitian itu dalam jurnalnya yang diproduksi oleh Elsevier, Lancet, Cell, etc. etc. Nah, jadi begitu, sehingga memang sangat menarik Elsevier dari 1970 hingga sekarang. Elsevier very very use big data about it, termasuk Elsevier.com ya, yang menyuplai ratusan ribu atau jutaan ya dari jurnal-jurnal yang memang juga qualified. So artificial intelligence operates an algorithm ya, and learn data pattern automatically. And if we in smartphone ya, that we use, we know about Google Assistant, image recognition for open handphone key ya, and healthy tracker app ya, application like on Fitbit or HelloDocs ya, and then PayPal for payment ya, and then Tokopedia. The existence ya of augmented reality technology and tourist attraction, maybe kalau kita bicara tourism industry ya, so robot waiters at hotel, chatbox that become travel agent administration ya, when we go down from bandara we get chatbox ya, welcome to mana Kuala Lumpur maybe ya, Indonesia, Bandung, Jakarta ya, welcome, and then we'll getting welcome remarks ya on the travel agent administration etc etc. So artificial intelligence is very very important, dan kemudian bagaimana dengan halal industri kita supaya bisa mendapat kinerja yang baik ya, dan bisa merekrut banyak ya consumers and abroad, specifically maybe in halal industry for tourism. So we need artificial intelligence. Ya, contoh sederhana dari Tokopedia itu. But how we can start? Ya, tidak bisa langsung besar. We need many cost, ya, big cost. Artificial intelligence or blockchain moreover. Ya, jadi bagaimana kita kemudian mendevelop halal industri kita secara realistis ya, secara yang bisa ya applicable ya, so kita bisa mulai dari yang lebih kecil skupnya. Contoh adalah Tokopedia dulu GoRide ya, dimulai dari GoRide, hanya mengantar ya ini ya, antar jemput sepeda motor, GoRide, only GoRide, but until now Gojek can develop their business more and more, apalagi ya collaborate with Tokopedia. Oh, this is a good synergy ya, using artificial intelligence. But Tokopedia still not use blockchain because blockchain is very very mahal. Very expensive ya. For the first setting, it's very high cost ya. Yeah. But in the next, this very very simplify and bisa menghemat lebih banyak ya. So memang untuk kekurangan blockchain ya, ada beberapa hal. Yang pertama cost ya, because although blockchain can reduce transaction cost, the system customization process can only be done by a handful of people. Jadi sedikit ya, sedikit yang bisa. Ya, blockchain technology relatively new, so there are still few experts. So students here, if you study not only at your subjects, yeah, but can at value ya about ya belajar autodidak ya about the technology ya about data analysis can study by self ya autodidak. And then if you graduate the company many looking for you and getting more valuable employee ya because the still few experts, this makes the manufacturing process very expensive, but it the first time because after that ya bisnis berjalan dengan baik based on blockchain, so akan menghemat banyak expense, ya. Yeah. And the second, ya, yeah, no environmentally friendly. Yeah, just a supercomputer uses the resources equivalent. Yeah, equivalent how many? For example, 100 ordinary computers. So how much power are consumed by thousands of supercomputer in the world? Ya, jadi banyak makan listrik. Nah, sehingga ini yang kemudian government. Nah, so in industry ecosystem ya, in halal ecosystem need support from government because this is the problem solution about the non environmentally friendly. Ya, can come from government solution. How about this? Ya, but the blockchain, ya. Until now is very very important. And the third of weakness ya yeah, of blockchain uses in crime memancing kejahatan. Because if misused crimes ya yeah, ya yeah, jika ini ya yeah, disalahgunakan untuk kejahatan ya. Yeah. So for example money laundering, illegal buying ya, yeah, illegal purchasing ya, yeah, it cannot be tracked because they do not have a control system. Because the key of blockchain ada control system yang tidak bisa dijebol oleh hacker sekali. Nah, itu ya. Nah, belum ada hacker menjebol blockchain, belum ada teknologi manusia, semuanya ada kelemahan kalau manusia yang sempurna ya hanya Allah semata. Nah, jadi artificial intelligence sangat rawan jika tidak di backup oleh blockchain. Ya, termasuk Tokopedia. We remember about the news that data in Tokopedia ya bocor ya. Nah, because only artificial intelligence he used. Yeah, not support by blockchain. Then this three of weakness yeah from blockchain. But the advantage yeah is very very many yeah accurate yeah cheaper for the next yeah is cheaper because reduce cost bigger ya yeah, in some blocks itu mengurangi cost and no server all data is copied and then distribute to all nodes in the network so and efficient ya yeah, efficient juga efficient and privacy ya yeah, khusus untuk user. Ya, privasi khusus untuk user. How about the blockchain and to halal tourism, for example? Ya, hanya turis yang setelah ada akad, ya, ada apply, kemudian make payment. So only the tourist A, only he, ya, that can open, ya, the application. So this is the privacy. Everyone can view transaction history, ya. Yeah. Everyone, I mean, is the consumer, ya, yeah, that have akad, ya, yeah, that have make payment, ya, yeah, with the tourism, ya, yeah, tourism field, ya. Yeah. Because blockchain, ya, yeah, operates like a public website. But this information is only limited to the name of the account in the network. not the identity of the account. Yeah, the owner account. Other account cannot access the personal data of other account owners. And then blockchain is safety. Yeah, open source and flexible. Oh, this is very, very good. Yeah, for blockchain using. And I know that some university develop about blockchain halal ecosystem. Yeah, in Indonesia, the develop yeah into halal ecosystem. And how about the future of blockchain? It's very important, yeah, because the development of blockchain technology has been very rapid in recent years and various applications through blockchain, yeah, have been developed to support various areas daily of life. Many companies are starting to adopt this technology, yeah, blockchain, in their operation, of course, yeah. And blockchain is also ready to help governments operate more accurately, efficiently, and at lower cost. Yeah, moreover, for our halal industry, this is the challenges. Yeah, halal industry and halal ecosystem, yeah, can build, yeah, based on blockchain for halal supply chain. Yeah, the blockchain support, yeah, by supply chain, etc. So it seems that it's only a matter of time blockchain will be used en masse in various parts of the world. So I think if we developing digital ecosystem, yeah, based on digitalization, yeah, digitalization, so it hopefully will be more getting efficient, yeah, in processing, yeah, and yeah, get more trust for customers and getting collaboration. Halal tourism in Indonesia, getting collaboration halal tourism in Malaysia, in United Arab Emirates, in every Islamic countries, it's possible to do. Yeah, I think, and for example, yeah, for example, because this is interesting when we talk about blockchain, yeah. So how about blockchain at wisata halal, yeah? Maybe, yeah, maybe we can try to, sorry, yeah, we can, how about the, sorry, we have here Adan. Maybe
we can what, doctor?
Yeah, I hear Adan. Maybe yes. We can. Yes.
Yeah, we can you. Break maybe 1 or 2
yes,
minutes.
Break. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Prof. Vivin.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Puji.
Professor Sri Aryani Niro.
Thank you very much.
Okay, I continue that, yeah. So why blockchain is very important, yeah, and more safe, yeah. So one of the most important aspects of blockchain technology is that data is decentralized, yeah, and this decentralized, yeah, with information being shared over a peer-to-peer network. Each block contains transactions and time information. Block are also permanent, yeah, and cannot be changed without the consensus of entire network and without changing subsequent blocks. Yeah, when we see my PowerPoint. This is very possible to do, to make blockchain system technology support. And this is in one area. So blockchain, kita harus paham juga bahwa blockchain tidak bisa untuk data yang kecil. Jadi kalau hanya spesifik, misalnya satu wilayah tidak bisa, tetapi akan perlu big data. Sehingga perlu ada masih banyak lagi terkait dengan stakeholder yang lain, tidak cukup halal tourism, halal value chain, Islamic finance, halal Islamic or halal related SME in one place, ya, melibatkan banyak wilayah juga. So the government, Indonesian government still think about this, yeah. I think Malaysia have been implemented about this. Indonesia can make collaboration in Lombok, yeah, and West Sumatra, Bandung, Surabaya. Oh, halal medical tourism is very very important too, yeah. Medical tourism, not only support by hospital, but halal tourism, and then halal fashion, halal restaurant, halal hotel, etc. Okay, that's all I think, yeah.
Okay, thank you, doctor. Second question. Wait, how do we respond to people's, from Muhammad Rifki Ali from Universitas Erlangga, how do we respond to people's negative paradigm of halal products that say they are the same as conventional products?
Oh, yeah, I see. Halal products is same with conventional
products.
So I think if we get the perception, just the same. Specifically, kalau halal tourism, no, ya. Kalau halal tourism, insya Allah very very specific and definitely very different. Yeah, halal fashion, it looks, very different. I think it's in apa itu halal, Islamic finance, ya, maybe, ya, Islamic finance. Ah, Ibu Puji ini yang harus menjelaskan, ya. Because yes, you are the lecturer of Islamic finance. I'm sorry, ya, Ibu Puji. Nah, so we need make sure that Islamic finance, halal finance is different with conventional. Maybe at superficial is different, is the same, but the soul, we can talk about the soul, the motivation, why we consume, why we use Islamic finance, why we use, we are being consumers of Islamic bank, because from our soul, our motivation, that is niat karena Allah Ta'ala, so this is the big differentiation, because from the niat, from the customer, and then how we are consume, so this is a different behavior, I think, maybe about saham and sukuk. So di intinya adalah sama, tapi ada bedanya juga. Islamic banking, we are consumers of BSI, Bank Syariah Indonesia. In the Di sisi yang lain, kita juga menjadi nasabah bank mandiri, bank konvensional. Tetapi, we use it separately function. So, jangan mudah terpancing juga ya. Jadi, berikan yang memberikan yang simpatik gitulah ya, untuk bisa menjelaskan, sehingga memang ini adalah berbeda. Like Islamic marketing and marketing, what the difference? Oh, very different, because the soul, yeah, like a knife, pisau. Knife when used by non-Muslim, when he menyembelih sapi, not baca basmalah. But if he a Muslim, take knife, untuk menyembelih, ayam, kambing, sapi selalu, dan itu wajib. Karena apa? Akan memberikan dampak yang sangat luar biasa. Apakah hewan itu halal untuk kita makan atau tidak? Nah, kalau penyembelihannya tidak menggunakan, tidak membaca nama Allah SWT, maka itu haram untuk kita makan. Tapi tidak tampak kan dalam kasat mata. Karena kita bisa berniat atau kita lafalkan. Tapi pas lafalnya orang tidak lihat, nah bisa jadi menganggap, oh sama saja, pisau sama saja, tapi beda. Selain marketing, is different too. How if we doing advertising in Islamic perspective? So this is very very different. Tidak boleh untuk menyampaikan yang consumerism, consumerism, bohong, ada syarat dan ketentuan. Wah, itu haram. Seperti itu tidak boleh. Jadi itu menipu. So this is kadang bisa disebut sebagai ethical marketing. But marketing as a strategy is general, semuanya baik ketika tidak kemudian memberikan efek yang negatif memberikan branding apalagi branding dengan memberikan branding nama Allah tidak boleh branding memberikan nama Nabi Muhammad for their products itu tidak boleh so we have norms, we have rules. When we are as an Islamic marketer getting or running running the business, running the marketing activities, so we have roles specific roles that itu tertanam dalam soul kita. Gitu, Bu Buji.
Okay, thank you, Dr. The last question. We just only have 3 minutes to answer this question. Okay. Because we need to finish about 14:45. So just need 3 minutes rest. Prof, what will be your advice for Muslim majority countries yet to look into or establish the halal industry? Your advice, why Muslim majority not establish the halal industry?
Okay. Sorry, rada bising di sini. Bisa di...
Okay. Yeah. Please give your advice for Muslim majority countries yet to establish the halal industry.
That's the choice. But I think this is the consequence dan tanggung jawab juga untuk kita siapapun itu, everyone who as a Muslim as a mu'min and then we know that in my slide at preamble so we do everything based on Islamic rules and we wake up must consume halal products everything apapun itu then consume halal media recreation so we must ensure we use halal for everything. Halal is lifestyle. Ya, halal is lifestyle. So we need understand about this. So ya belum menyadari untuk itu manusia. Oleh karena itu perlu untuk kemudian kita ada sosialisasi, ada sharing, ada aktivitas ya namanya sharing gitu ya dengan our friends, our networks, not just in our university, our more narrow, our department, not only. So Muslim sudah dicontohkan oleh Nabi Muhammad untuk kemudian memiliki network yang luas ya, we can silaturahmi ya, so students from Erlangga can silaturahmi with students from University of Malaya and then making collaboration about something, about research, about anything ya, that we fun ya, that we enjoy about this. So and then we can by social media we have new friends from abroad, etc. that from Islamic countries ya, yeah, ada Islamic countries ya, yeah, from Pakistan, from others ya, yeah, others. So we can start to talk about how ya, yeah, to implementation about halal economy, halal ecosystem ya, yeah, and that's very very important. So we always make a motivation that kalau kita bangun tidur banyakkan ya, dan memang harus begitu, kita consume halal products, everything ya, everything, dan jadikan halal itu sebagai lifestyle itu, sehingga kita ketika kemudian apa ya, memahami halal tidak hanya untuk food and beverage but all ya, yeah, all. So halal have a broad meaning ya, yeah, halal have broad meaning, not only food and beverage but everything that yang terlibat dengan aktivitas kita sehari-hari, memenuhi kebutuhan kita sehari-hari, kita upayakan untuk bisa kemudian mengkonsum yang halal, apapun itu. Gitu ya. Itu. Terima kasih Ibu Puji, itu saja.
Oke, thank you Dr. Ririn. Alhamdulillahirabbil alamin. We already finish our guest lecture second part from Student Mobility Program. We want to thank Dr. Ririn. Maybe all of you can virtual applause to her. And thank you to all participants who have participated in this event. Okay, I think that's all for me. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Back return to MC.
Okay. Thank you to Dr. Ririn Tri Ratnasari for the precious knowledge, mm-hmm, and Mrs. Puji Suciya Sukmaningrum for guiding the session. Now, we have some short quiz that you can take through Kahoot.it. If you know Kahoot, like a game, a little game, to the comedy, please help me to share the screen. Okay, maybe we will wait for 1 minute. Okay. You can write www.kahoot.it on your search engine and put the game pin 7015804 7015804. And please to write your real name, because in the end of this game, the committee will give the prize for the winner. So if you are able to join this game, I invite all of you, because it only takes 10 questions and doesn't take much time. If you are able, I invite all the audiences, to all the brothers and sisters from Universitas Airlangga and University of Malaya, please join us to play this game. It's about the material from Dr. Ririn. Okay, it's just equal and now 9. Maybe I will wait until 14, 18. 2 minutes again. From 78 participants, if you are able to join us. Like LCP, maybe if we call in Indonesia, like lomba cepat tepat. I don't know what people call in Malaysia. But you will see the question on your screen, and you can choose the answer from there on your device. Okay, it's still 16 people. Again, I invite to all my brothers and sisters from Universitas Airlangga and University Malaya if you are able to join us for this game. Please. And of course, at the end of the session, the committee will give you a prize if you become a winner, for third winner. Maybe we will until 1 minute again. And please use your real name. Okay, it's just 23 people. And it's already 2 minutes again, so I invite all of you, if you are able to join us, please stream, and we will give the prize for 3 winners in this afternoon. It's already 25 people, 172. I guarantee this is going to be hard because it's about the material from this afternoon, and it's only 10 questions. There's only 24 people want to join us, or we can start this game. Okay. 25 people? Okay. 23, we will start. If there is no people want to join us, maybe we will start this game for now. Okay. I remind all of you, for every question, it takes just only 10. Okay. For the first question, who is the biggest halal meat supplier for Indonesia? If you put your attention, you will know the question. I still remember the answer. So, the answer for the first question is Australia. Okay, the biggest halal meat supplier for Indonesia is Australia. Okay, we will go to the next question. For the first winner for this question is Mbak Mira. Okay, the second question is a statement. You can choose, is it true or false? Developing halal system logistic based food chain technology is one of the research development on halal systems. About blockchain, Dr. Rimun already telling us for many times. And yeah, is it true? Developing halal system logistic-based blockchain technology is one of the research development and halal system. Okay, just only one people who choose false. And now for the first winner is, I'm not sure, is it Mr. or Miss? I think it's Mr. Sakti Silan. Okay, we go to the next question. For the third question, oh, it's only 5 questions. Total spend of halal food in 2018 in the world is, wow, it's a little bit. I'm not sure if I participant, but we will see who choose the right answer. Okay, just 6 people. Total spend of halal food in 2018 in the world is only, not it's only, it's a big total amount. It's $1.37 billion. Okay, we got the new winner again. It's Miss Sazana, and the second winner is Mbak Mira, and the third winner is Mbak Nisrina. For the fourth question, the following are the government's work pillars for halal industry. If you remember, there are super pillars for halal industry. And maybe it's not that tricky for. Okay, just no. It's quite amount. It's 13 people who choose the right answer, decreasing institutional effectiveness. It's not the one of super pillars. Okay, Miss Sazana is still become the first winner for this scoreboard. Now we go to the last question. It's a statement. You can choose true or false. China is the biggest supplier of Muslim fashion products. Okay, it's the same slide on with the biggest meat supplier for Indonesia. Okay, we'll see. Oh, okay, just it's like half participant for to choose the right answer. Yes, China is the biggest supplier of Muslim fashion products. Okay, we'll see for the third winner on this. This is Miss Salsabila, and the second winner is Miss Jimmy. And now we will see for the first winner is Miss Mia. So congratulations to all the winner of this quiz. You can contact the committee for to get your prize. Okay. Thank you for your participation. And now we have finished our second guest lecture for this morning from Universitas Airlangga. Before we proceed to the closing of this class, I invite all of the audiences to participate in the photo session. You may turn the camera on, and the committee will help to capture the Zoom screen. So right now there are 3 screens in the Zoom, and the committee will capture the screen maybe once. For all the audiences, please be prepared. And if you are able to open your camera, please join us for the documentation. Okay. And I remind all of you don't forget to fill the feedback form that the committee will that already put in the chat box. So there are 3 screens, and I invite all the audiences, my brothers and sisters from Universitas Airlangga and University Malaya from 2 countries. This is the opportunity for you to make the relationship. So maybe if you are able to open your camera, okay? just only one screen?
Okay, Fusa, I will start now.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. I start to take a photo. Slide one. One, two, three. And then slide two. One, two, three. And then slide three. One, two, three. Okay, thank you.
Thank you to Miss Zizi. Finally, we come to the end of the second class for this morning. To close this event, let's recite Hamdallah together. Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin. To all the audiences, I remind all of you, please don't forget to fill the attendance link as feedback form that the committee already put in the chat box before. Representing the organizing committees, I feel Zatahira. We'd like to say thank you very much for your participation today, and we do apologize for our mistakes in presenting this event. Thank you for your attention, and we hope to see you again for the next time. I end my duty as Master of Ceremony for afternoon's event with Billahi Taufiq wal Hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Barakallah
semua, ibu-ibu.
Iya, terima kasih, thank you very much.
Jumpa lagi ya.
Ya, jumpa lagi.
Insyaallah.
Waalaikumsalam. Buririn, PPT-nya Buririn.
Share di. Tadi iya, saya tidak bisa share di Zoom. Jadi saya share.
Iya,
maaf.
Selamat Bu. Barakallah.
Materinya
Buririn memang sangat menarik gitu.
Iya.
Baik. Ade bisa share mungkin.
Ibu, insyaallah akan kami share ini PPT-nya ke peserta.
Baik, terima kasih. Saya
pamit dulu.
Oh ya, Ade lewat Zoom, Ade. Saya kopas siap. Dua kali, tidak bisa itu.
Oh, Masya Allah. Baik, Bu.
Iya.
Belagi ya semua. Assalamualaikum.
Iya, terima kasih. Waalaikumsalam. Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Iya.
Izin pamit, Bapak, Ibu,
teman-teman. Ini ngetahin PPT ya.
Oh, iya, iya.
Baik, saya share di grup.
Belum dapat,
ya, saya share di grup juga.
Oh iya,
oh, iya siap.
Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum.
Sama-sama, makasih.
Assalamualaikum.
Ibu Buci, Mbak.